Okay, so can you hear me? So thank you for very much for the introduction. This is official title of my talk, but I should probably change it to, it's the wrong presentation. 1 second, please. But I should probably change it to collective behavior in biomechanical hybrid system. So you may ask me, what is my biomechanical hybrid systems and why we are so interested in studying it? And if you go to Department of Energy website, you will find a few grand challenges. And one of the grand challenge is to discover general principles describing the systems far from equilibrium to enable efficient and robust biologically inspired machines. So in other words, the government wants us to create something which combines the properties of engineered mechanical materials and living organisms. I don't know if you can see it, but this is like a Robocop. And one of the, so the systems, they can adapt to environmental changes, they can respond to stimuli, and more importantly, they can, since they're alive, they can self-heal damages. And before playing with the humans hybrids, biomechanical hybrids, so we decided to start with something a little bit simpler with swimming bacteria. So I'm sure that many of you have seen this movie, so similar movies many times, but yeah, Bacillus subtilis and many other bacteria like E. coli, they're pretty good swimmers. By rotating helical filaments, flagella, they can swim pretty fast. And what is interesting that if you increase the concentration of bacteria, they start to swim collectively, like here, which is manifested by the formation of large-scale vortices, jets, flows. And the correlation length of velocity field is much larger than individual size of a single bacterium. And you might think that since they swim collectively, probably bacteria should be aligned parallel to each other, and it should look like a pneumatic material. But in reality, this is not the case. It turns out if you zoom in on a fraction of this collective behavior, bacteria are not very well aligned. So the orientation is pretty much random. So while there is like a long-range orientational order for velocities, there is no long-range orientation for bacterial orientation. But we can fix it by putting bacteria inside synthetic material, liquid crystal. So fortunately, there is a liquid crystal which is not toxic for bacteria. It's a allotropic liquid crystal. Basically, it's a mixture of salt and water, and a certain range of salt concentration and certain range of temperature, this material goes to the pneumatic phase. And by mixing bacteria with the liquid crystal, we create what we call living liquid crystal. So it's a synthetic material combining the properties of life matter, such as bacteria, self-propulsion, with the properties of liquid crystals, such as long-range orientational order, anisotropic viscosity, and anisotropic elasticity. So before talking about the results of our work, I just want to quickly describe the technique we used. It's called cross-polarized microscopy. So like long story short, basically this is a standard technique to study liquid crystal. So by transmitting the polarized light through the liquid crystal and blocking it with the second polarizer perpendicular to the first one, you get the image, and intensity allows you estimate the orientation of molecules of liquid crystal. So what we did, we put this liquid crystal inside, sandwiched basically between two glass plates, treated in a special way. I don't know if you can see them, but these are bacteria. So the director field, which is parallel to the orientation of molecules of liquid crystal, is uniform everywhere. And as you can see, the bacteria swim parallel to this director field. That happens because of the two reasons. So first, since the viscosity of liquid crystal is highly anisotropic, the drag in this direction is much less than drag in perpendicular direction. That's why bacteria prefer to swim this way. But also, if you immerse like any even immotile object, elongated object in a liquid crystal, it will align parallel to the director field just to minimize the free energy. But you can also see that swimming bacteria, flagella, creates a wave which is visible using like the optical microscope. And that's quite interesting because flagella is only 24 nanometers wide, and it's not possible to see it in optical microscope without like fluorescent tricks, for example. But if we use liquid crystal, we can visualize the dynamic of flagella. We can measure pitch. We can measure frequency of the rotation. And that's quite useful tool because, for example, in this experiment, two bacteria swimming next to each other. Like, so they swim parallel to each other, and while they are approaching, the difference in their swimming speed is reducing. But what is even more interesting, that the difference in the frequencies of flagella rotation is also reducing. So this is dashed line frequency of flagella rotation. And this is an evidence of hydrodynamic synchronization between flagella and different bacteria. And this may be quite important because the synchronization of flagella may be one of the reasons why at high concentration, bacteria swim much more efficiently and much faster than at low concentration. What is also was quite puzzling that in spite of the fact that a liquid crystal is very viscous medium, the viscosity is by 100 or 1,000 times larger than the viscosity of water, bacteria swim still pretty fast. So the blue line represents the velocity distribution, and as you can see, the average swimming speed is about 15 microns per second, which is only 25% less than the swimming speed of the bacteria in water, 20 microns per second. The rotation rate of the flagella in water is about 100 hertz. The rotation rate in liquid crystal is 15 hertz, so it's 7 times less. But the swimming speed is only by 25% less, which means that while in water, single bacterium travels 0.15 micron per each rotation of flagella, somehow in liquid crystal, the same bacterium travels 1 micron per each rotation of flagella. So it's like a corkscrew motion, much more efficient. And the reason why it happens is that in liquid crystal, the flow created, the bacteria virtually swim inside a channel, inside a tube. So since the viscosity is very high, is very anisotropic, the flow created by a single bacterium is allocated along the line parallel to the bacterial body. So the flow decays very slowly in this direction and very fast in the perpendicular direction. That's a very important result because if we have many bacteria or a few bacteria, their interaction range is highly anisotropic. So they interact at very large distance if they're on the same line, on the same trajectory, and they don't interact if they're on the different lines, even if they're very close to each other. And in this movie, for example, you can see that this fluorescent tracer, this white spot, will be transferred by the bacteria while the bacteria is quite far, 100 microns from this particle. I don't know if you will be able to see it, but we will try. So, yeah. Sorry, it's not visible. But this particle is moved by the bacteria while the bacteria is quite far from this particle, but at the same line. And before talking about the collective behavior, I just want to quickly show you a few quite interesting tricks how we can guide bacteria. For example, we can create such a configuration of liquid orientation of liquid crystal, like, I don't know, star configuration. Then all bacteria, since they're swimming parallel to the director field, they will swim towards the center and away from the center. So they will concentrate in the center of this star. But if we create like a vortex configuration like here, it's even more interesting. Bacteria will think that they are fish now, and they will school. And take a note that there is certain type of instability, so you can see the formation of wave like this. And the mechanism why you see this instability, well, basically you can see like three wavelengths, three periods here, four periods here. So there, the mechanism is the collective interaction between bacteria. So basically, this is the collective behavior. Of course, we can create a system of vortices, interacting vortices or non-interacting vortices. So you see, here you can see like basically four different schools of bacteria. So the reason why you saw these waves is following. So remember, I told you that the bacteria, the range, the interacting range of the bacteria is quite large if they're on the single trajectory, on the same line. So if you have one bacteria, the velocity field decays very slowly in this direction, but still decays. And if there is another bacteria here, the hydrodynamic forces created by the first bacteria acting on the head and the tail of another bacteria are different. And because of this, the first bacteria introduces a torque. And this torque, hydrodynamic interaction between bacteria tends to misalign bacteria. While elastic forces, and liquid crystal is highly elastic material, tends to align them back. And the interplay between elastic forces and hydrodynamic interaction defines the wavelength of this instability you saw. And this, in this experiment, for example, the first, we make bacteria immotile temporarily by cutting off the oxygen. So we reduce the oxygen concentration to zero, they become non-motile, and they align parallel to the director field uniformly everywhere. So their orientation is like this everywhere. And then if you use a cross-polarized microscopy, you don't see anything. You'll see like a black color. But then we introduce oxygen to the system from the left side, and bacteria start to swim. They start to interact, and they create bending instability. And this bending instability can be observed using, again, cross-polarized microscopy as a stripes. And these stripes propagate to the right with the diffusion of oxygen. So if you continue to increase the activity of the bacteria or concentration of bacteria, you can create like a turbulent motion, like in this movie. So it's very similar to what I showed you on the first slide, but now it's a little bit slower. But what is more important, that now bacteria are very well aligned with each other. So it's a turbulence in the pneumatic material, pneumatic medium. And you can see the formation of defects here. I'm not going to talk about it, but that's a very rich system, and we continue to study it now. And at the very last few minutes, I want So you saw that bacteria may behave like a fish, and now I'll show you that they can behave like ants. So before I talk to you about, so in the previous experiment, the orientation of liquid crystal was parallel to the glass plates. So it's called a planar orientation. We can also create a homeotropic orientation. Then the liquid crystal is perpendicular to the glass plates. And then, if the bacteria is relatively short and not very fast, it will become, it will be aligned parallel to the liquid crystal molecules perpendicular to the glass plates. It will spin the flagella, but it will remain vertical. And this bacteria is seen as a, from the top as a dots here. But some bacteria, if they're relatively long, and more importantly, if they're powerful enough, they can escape this vertically trapped state and become swimming, horizontally swimming. For example, in this video, you see that now most of the bacteria are vertical, but then we introduce oxygen to the system, they start to swim, and they escape this vertical state and start to swim horizontally. What you can also notice that each bacterium will create a white trace. And this trace is basically, you'll see in another movie. So this trace is a disturbance of a initially vertically oriented director field. So swimming bacteria creates a such configuration, like, I don't know, a funnel configuration, and attracts other bacteria to the trace. And you can see in this movie that, for example, there is a few bacteria traveling next to each other, three bacteria. So the first bacteria create a trace, and other bacteria follow this trace. So, and you may find another example, then the bacteria, for example, here, find like a trace from the previous bacteria and start to follow, because swimming along this trajectory is easier than swimming somewhere else. And I think this is the end of my talk. I just want to thank my collaborators and ready to answer your questions.